about you?
I don't believe you.
Why not, Lizzie? What are you scared of?
You. I don't trust you.
What don't you trust about me?
Everything. The way you talk, the way you brag, why even your name?
What's wrong with my name?
It sounds fake. It sounds like you made it up.
Well, you're darn right. I did make it up.
Fair. Of course.
Well, what do you expect? You know the name I was born with? Smith. Smith, for the love of Mike, Smith. Now what kind of a handle is that for a fellow like me? I needed a name with the entire sky and the power of man. Star Buck. Now there's a name, and it's mine.
No, it's not. You were born Smith, and that's my name.
You're wrong. The name you choose for yourself is more your own name than the one you were born with. And if I were you, I would definitely choose another name than Lizzie.
Thank you. I'm very pleased with it.
No, you ain't. You ain't pleased with nothing but yourself. And you definitely aren't pleased with Lizzie.
I don't ask you to be pleased with it, Starbuck. I am.
Lizzie, why don't you even stand for anything?
It stands for me. Me, I'm not the Queen of Sheba. I'm not Lady Godiva, and I'm not Cinderella at the ball.
Would you like to be?
Oh, Starbuck, you're ridiculous.
What's ridiculous? Dream you're somebody? Be somebody. Lizzie, that's nobody. So many wonderful women with wonderful names. Leonora, Desdemona, Christina, Diana, Florinda, Annabella. Lizzie.
Good night, Starbuck.
Oh, wait a minute. What just happened? I've got the greatest name, the greatest. Just listen. Melisandre. Well, that's because you don't know anything about her. Mm-hmm. But when I tell you who she was, oh, miss, when I tell you who she was.
Who?
Why, she was the most beautiful wife of King Harold. Ever heard of him?
Go on. Go on.
Well, he's the fellow who sailed across the ocean and brought back the Golden Fleece. And you want to know why he did that? Because Queen Melisandre beckoned you. God, she was so beautiful, and her hair was so long and curly. Every time he would just look at her, he would just fall right down and die. And that King Hamlet, he would do anything for her, anything she wanted. So when she said, Hamlet, I've got a terrible hankering for some golden fleece, he just naturally sailed right off the final. And when he came back, all torn and bleeding, he laid the fur piece down at her pretty white feet. And she picked up the fur piece and wrapped it around her naked pink shoulders and said, I've got the fur piece. I'll be cold no more. Melisandre, what a woman. What a name.
Starbuck, you silly fool. You take a lot of stories that I've read in 100 different places and you roll them up with one big, fat, ridiculous lie.
I wasn't lying. I was dreaming. Well, if you think it's the same thing, then I take back what I said about your name. Lizzie, it's just right for you. You know another name that'll suit you? No. Because you and your brother, you got no dreams.
You think all dreams have to be your kind? Golden fleece and thunder on the mountain. But there are other kinds of dreams, Starbuck. The quiet ones that come to a woman when she's shining the silverware, or when moth flies in the closet.
Like what?
Like a man's voice saying, Lizzie, is my blue suit pressed? And the same man saying, scratch between my shoulder blades. And kids laughing and teasing and setting up a racket. How it feels to say the word husband. There are all kinds of dreams, Mr. Starbuck, mighty small, like my name, Lizzie. But they are real, like my name, real. So you can have yours. And I'll have mine.
Lizzie.
Please.
Lizzie, I'm sorry.
It's all right. Just let me go.
I hope your dreams come true. I really do.
They won't. They never will.
Believe in yourself, and they will.
I have nothing to believe in.
You're a woman. Believe in that.
How can I when nobody else will?
You have to believe it first. Let me ask you this. Do you think you're pretty?
No, I'm plain.
You see? You don't even know you're a woman.
I am a woman, a plain one.
There's no such thing as a plain woman. Every woman is pretty. They're pretty in different ways, but they're still pretty.
I'm not. When I look in the looking glass,
don't let no one be your looking glass. gotta be inside you. And then one day, it'll be the man that loves you. His eyes, maybe. And then you'll be more than pretty. You'll be beautiful.
It'll never happen.
Make it happen. Think pretty. Let down your hair.
No!
Lizzie, please. Because when you say you're pretty, it's true. Lizzie, stop crying and look at me. Lizzie, stop crying and look in my eyes. What do you see?
I can't believe what I see.
Tell me what you see.
My mother's kitchen, and sometimes a teaspoon will fall down into that garbage disposal. Yeah, so like, you know how you feel when you have to reach down there into that garbage disposal and feel around down there for that teaspoon? Oh, you can do it. Who knows what's down there? Could be garbage, a piece of something. So much goes down there. Or germs, which you can't see. You can't see germs, but if they're going to be anywhere, they're going to be down that disposal. Well, they grow there, see? They come back up and flirt. Yeast? Cancer? Cold, who knows? But Barry, you hold out on that. What if? And I'm just saying what if, because it'll probably never happen. What if the garbage disposal came on their hands up down there? I'm so scared thinking about it. I usually leave the teaspoon down there. I don't even try to get it out. I make a huge racket, and I stand in the middle of the kitchen, and the teaspoon goes around. And I get sort of paralyzed, you know? It makes a lot of noise, incredible noise. But Barry, I kind of like that noise. I know the teaspoon's getting destroyed and annihilated. I hate the teaspoon for scaring me like that. So it's not just the disposal, it's everything. What about insects? Termites? Hornets? Spiders, ants, centipedes, mites. I can't even see the mites. They're like the jars, tiny. I like things clean, you know? 3 ashtrays bother me. The mailman brings me unsolicited mail with the postage stamp written by somebody with AIDS. Right? And my mother is a threat to my life for persisting and going out there. No, there's a dust storm in California with these little fungus spores in it, and they get in people's lungs, they get inside their bloodstreams, and they grow inside them, kills them! Stranger! Stranger! Ah!
Wendy seemed to get fatter until finally by the second act she was immobile and had to remove her cart. You remember how in the second act, Tinkerbell takes the poison that Peter's about to drink in order to save him? And then Peter turns to the audience and he says that Tinkerbell's going to die because not enough people believe in fairies. But that if everybody claps real hard to show they do believe in fairies, then maybe Tinkerbell won't die. So then everybody started to clap.
Every night when I get home.
That's the point. I never know when you're going to get home.
Then a reference to some financial pressures that have surfaced lately, making this unlikely.
Question about what he means. He's thinking that he took a job with more hours so they could have enough money to be spontaneous.
Reference to their recent vacation in Aruba as something spontaneous.
Retort that Frank spent the entire vacation working on his new laptop.
Reply that all Dana wanted to do was visit the swim up bar.
Question of a line I was thinking there was a jewelry store purchased on a credit card. which hope with all us girls, most of us would like to come back, and we can't. There's always to it. We can't work out of this life because we don't know how. We was never taught how.
Maybe I'm brainless, maybe I'm wise, but you've got me seeing through different eyes. Somehow I've fallen under a spell, and somehow I'm feeling it's all that I make up for lost time. Say.
mercy on me.
And with all